This right here is LG's SJ4Y 2.1 channel 300 watt soundbar. I've already done an unboxing for this soundbar, I'll leave the links to it in the description box, and now let's bring in the review. Let's start by talking about the build quality. This soundbar is pretty much all made out of plastic, there's no metal parts outside of the bar and on the wireless subwoofer, so it feels plasticky, but it doesn't look like a plastic material. It has nice designs and it does look great on my table. The remote control that it comes with, it is small, but I don't mind it since it does what it's supposed to do and it has a very simple design just like the soundbar. The setup process was also very simple. All I had to do was plug it in, turn it on, and I was able to connect it to my phone directly without having to do anything else, and the subwoofer connected itself. This has a couple of different modes. You can obviously connect it to your TV directly and then use it like that, but I use it over Bluetooth. So far, it's been doing the job just fine. I have no connectivity issues. There's no signal breaking when I'm going upstairs or if I'm playing music from my phone. And also when I'm watching movies, there's no audio latency, so that's a plus. One really cool thing about this soundbar, I actually found this out today, is that when the soundbar is off and I connect it to my phone via Bluetooth, the soundbar automatically turns on and starts playing the music. On the backside of the soundbar, there's the optical in port, HDMI port, HDMI out port, and also a USB port. So far, I am satisfied with my purchase. If I compare this to my Bose Solo 5, which is a $250 soundbar, this has a better sound and the bass sounds better on this. But, you know, it's two different soundbars. The Bose is smaller and this is bigger. But overall, this is a great soundbar. And this concludes the video. Thank you for watching.
Table's vibrating. I mean, why would it not?
The wall's vibrating, I gotta stop.